Good morning children, how are you all? Welcome to Max Class. Today we are going to learn unit 6, time. Children, is the sky looks same all the time? No, we can see the sun during daytime and we can see the stars and moons during night time. Children, we already learned times of a day in our previous class. Let's recall.
Children, how many days are there in a week? Yes, there are 7 days in a week. How many months are there in a year? Yes, there are 12 months in a year. Tell me children, how do we calculate these days? Yes, we learnt it in social science. By the rotation and revolution of the earth, we calculate day and night and days.
Children, look at this picture. In this picture, one side we have sun, that is daytime. On the other side, we have moon and the stars, that is night time. Children, how do we calculate day and night? Yes, by the movement of earth. The earth moves in two ways. It spins and it moves around the sun. The spinning of the earth is called rotation. It takes the earth about 24 hours to make one complete rotation. That is one day. Children, at the same time, the earth is moving around the sun. This is called a revolution. It revolves 365 times to go one round around the sun, which means 365 days. This we call it as 1 year.
There are two types of clock. One is digital clock or 24 hours format clock. Another one is non-digital clock, which is 12 hours format clock. Children, there are 24 hours in a day. We are using 12 hours format clock. 12 hours format clock shows the numerals 1 to 12. 24 hours format clock shows the numerals 1 to 24. Children, the 12 hour system is divided into 2 periods. The first 12 hour mentioned as AM. It runs from the midnight to noon. The second 12 hours is mentioned as PM. It runs from noon to midnight.
Children, let's see the chronological order and cyclic order. Children, have you noticed when your mother preparing idli? Yes. First, she soaks rice and black gram in water. Second, she grinds them to prepare a batter. Third, she ferments the batter overnight. Fourth, she boils the batter to make idlis. Children, these events occur in an order in the process of making idlis. Chronological order is the method of arranging the events in the order of their happening. For example, our education system. First, we have to join KG, which is pre-KG, and then LKG, UKG, 1st standard, 2nd standard, 3rd standard, 4th standard, etc. It is the chronological order. And then germination of seed. First seed, next stem, root grows, and then grow,
and then leaf. It is also the example for chronological order.
Let's complete the exercise. Write F for the event which comes first and N for the event which happens next. Children, observe these and answer which comes first and which comes next. First one, eating, cooking. Tell me children, which one is first? Yes, first we have to cook. So, write F for cooking and then we have to eat. Write N for eating. Second one, boarding into a bus or train, reaching the destination. Tell me children, which one comes first? Yes, first we have to board into a bus or train. After that only, we can able to reach the destination. So, write F for boarding into a bus or train and write N for reaching the destination. Third one, drawing a picture, coloring. Tell me children, which one comes first? Yes, first we have to draw a picture. So, write F for drawing a picture. Next, we have to color. Write N for coloring. Fourth one, taking out a book from the bag, reading. Which one comes first? Yes, first we have to take the book from the bag. Write F for taking out a book from the bag. And N for reading. Fifth one, opening the door, entering the room. Tell me children, which one comes first? Yes, first we have to open the door. After that, we can enter the room. Write F for opening the door and N for entering the room. Children, let's arrange these events in chronological order. First, started walking, birth, started schooling in class 1, studying in class 3, studying in class 2. Tell me children, which one comes first? Yes, birth. And then started walking. Next, started schooling in class 1. Next, studying in class 2. Next, studying in class 3. Second one, sowing seeds, plucking fruits, growing fruit, flowering in plant, watering plants. Children, observe these and tell me the order. Yes, first sowing seeds, next watering plants, next flowering in plant, next growing fruit and plucking fruits.
Next, cycling event. Children, every day we wake up in the morning and go to the bed at night. Every day the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. This process keeps on repeating every day. Children, events that keep on repeating in the same manner without much differences is cyclic event. For example, yesterday I came to school, today I am in school, tomorrow I will come to school. This event is repeating. It is cyclic event. And then clock. Clock rotating repeatedly. It is also cyclic event.
and then days of the week. Days of the week repeated in a same manner. It is also cyclic event.
List the events that form a cycle and that do not form a cycle. Children, here we have some events. We have to identify whether it forms a cycle or do not form a cycle. First one, coming to school. Yes, coming to school is a cyclic event. We are coming to school every day. Second one, rotation of a clock. Rotation of a clock is also cyclic event because it rotates every day. Third one, days of a week. Days of a week also form a cycle. It repeats again and again. Fourth one, growth of your pet. Children, growth of your pet does not form a cycle. Next, building your house. Building your house do not form a cycle. Once we construct the building, it's over. Next, making of Italy. Making of Italy also not form a cycle. Once we cook, the process gets over. Children, let's complete the events of given cycle. First, we have days of a week. We already learned days of a week. After Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Next, seasons of a year. Summer, winter, and rainy.
Thank you, children.